So you're defensively ready to take a punch. He's going to do one that was in one of their books. He's going to break his metal lock, but it's resting on glasses. And he's going to use the glass to break it. So accuracy is most important, not power. Because should he shatter the glass in his hand, it cuts it. It has to be done properly the first time, so he has to be quiet.
Some systems think this is a down block,
harm the children are going to do for you.
Smash through four twin concrete blocks. We ask you to be quiet until all this happens. inside.
We always use real wood. some empty hand forms. This one is a tension form. As the student goes through it, he has to use all the principles of karate. He has to be in a form of meditation. I go around and kick them or punch them and break wood over their body, and they're to keep doing the form without looking around. You do not learn this form until you've been in our school for over a year. It sometimes takes another year to perfect it. In karate, we take two unlikes and put them together as one. The sun and the moon, unalike, yet they must work together to make the world possible. Man and woman, unalike, yet they must work together to make the world possible. And in karate, we take the same two unlikes. We take your arm and your leg and coordinate it as one. We take your internal muscle and your external muscle and coordinate it as one. And last but not least, the mind and the body must function in one. You'll see all that displayed here in our ending.
That judging by the crowds that flock to see every new Chuck Norris movie, most people are as fascinated as I am by these talented and skilled people. Now, Reading, Pennsylvania is a long way from Hollywood, but there's a man who lives in Reading by the name of George Dillman. He is indeed a real-life Bruce Lee. To introduce to you this unique man, let's go to Reading, Pennsylvania, and George Dillman.
Like a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, I have to totally leave what I call reality, and I become another person. I just go crazy. I go into a trance. I go into another world, and it's the same kind of trance you would have to get in if you were in a fight situation.
The knee is used defensively to block against kicks. Someone kicks at you, we use the leg to stop it, so we counteract with the hands.
George Dillman, black belt karate expert. Attention exercise shows his students that the body can break unbreakable objects. And the body can bear unbearable pain.
There are 500 acupressure points in the body, or acupuncture points, that an acupuncturist can put needles. Well, when they put the needle this way, that might heal or soothe. But when I come in the other way, it causes damage, it causes pain. And with that, with the fingertips, I can actually knock people out.
Okay.
Let me at him.
To be a student of George Dillman, as witness here, one must completely trust this black belt karate expert. In fact, Dillman contends that if a good boxer were to study under him, he'd be a world champion.
If I were to work with Jerry Cooney, he would beat Larry Holmes. If I were to work with Thomas Hearns, he would have beat Marvelous Hagler. It's just that simple. He would have to believe me, he would have to trust me, and he would have to spend 2 months in a ring with me to get these points. And at that point, he could take anybody, and I could reverse boxing history.
The most dramatic aspect of a Dillman demonstration comes when he prepares to slice two watermelons in half with a razor-sharp sword while blindfolded.
I build a mental picture of everything that's going on out there, and then with the years of practice that I've had with that sword doing what we call kata, or forms, I know that the blade is going to be on target. I just have to get a mental picture of where the watermelons are.
Dillman and his students are world famous for their breaking skills. Dillman breaking as much as 1,200 pounds of ice with his bare elbow.
Breaking is a show portion of karate. We jump up and break wood, we break boards, the public likes to see it, but we only do that once or twice in a year. The real study of karate is this inner peace that you get.
Boy, I'll bet you Tommy Hearns is glad to know now that he could have beaten Marvelous Marvin Hagler if he'd trained under George Dillman. I think I'd rather fight Marvin Hagler than train under George Dillman.